Hello everyone. Narcissist Free Almost here, and today I wanted to share some tips I use for spotting a narcissist quickly, in hopes of avoiding disaster. I'm usually giving this one a lot of thought, of course, because it's better to spot one and get away, than to be ensnared by one and destroyed. I'm sure you would agree with me. But the number one thing that narcissists do is hide. They are expert at hiding who they really are, because if you're honest, no one in the world would have anything to do with them otherwise, except their mother, maybe. For that reason, I rely heavily on what I call my too much rule, among a few other things. My too much rule is just that: a person's behavior is just too much in one way or another. For example, a narcissist is often too friendly in the beginning, or too generous, or too helpful, etc. This rule is the gatekeeper for me, and the first thing I notice about a person. Because I know there are people that can be very friendly, or helpful, or generous by nature, I will give them the benefit of the doubt, not always, but often. Which leads me to my next rule of three strikes you're out. The first strike comes when you break my too much rule, and I throw the caution flag. I consider that this may just be a one-off, or have a valid reason behind the flag, and I'll let that go, but remain vigilant. The second strike arises when the behavior happens again, and now I'm very alert, but will again cautiously categorize it as a coincidence. Mainly, because I probably like the person and really don't want them to be toxic. I know this could be construed as wishful thinking on my part, but I'm one to give the benefit of the doubt. By the way, be careful with that, and making excuses for someone. That used to be a bad habit of mine that the narcissist relied heavily on, and took full advantage. Once you get to number two, number three, sadly, isn't far behind. This is going to be your stop sign, because now you have a pattern, and once you've established a pattern of behavior, they have to go. That doesn't mean being rude and telling them what you've observed, but politely and quietly stepping aside, not allowing a relationship to take hold. Another thing you might notice in the beginning is underlying aggression. A pathological narcissist, or other toxic person will have a personality fueled by aggression. Aggression colors their perception, and symptoms manifest as chronic irritability, flash anger, and gritted teeth. This could also look like argumentativeness, always having to be right, and, or, always having to have the last word. A fourth behavior I've noticed that helps me avoid a toxic person is invalidation. In its most subtle form, it looks like disagreement. Here I'm not saying that if someone disagrees with you they are toxic, not at all. What I am saying is that this person is disagreeable with you in general, for no good reason. For example, two people are standing outside in freezing cold weather, and one points out how uncomfortable the weather is, and the other, who is the toxic one, will say, in a rather flippant manner, "No, not really, not cold at all." Huh? You might say to yourself, clearly it's cold, what an odd thing to disagree about. On the surface this seems like nothing, and you brush it off feeling slightly annoyed and momentarily confused at the response, but if you look a little deeper, you will see that this response is one of contempt. Likely the body language will convey a haughty appearance as the toxic person seems to brush you off. This is often the kind of responses you will get from a narcissist, as masters of invalidation, that scream of contempt. Being very sensitive to this one now is usually a stop sign for me. Contempt is a dead giveaway that you're dealing with some type of toxic person, and frankly, this one does not deserve the benefit of the doubt. Lastly, does the person you're getting to know gossip? I know not all gossip is malicious, but coming from a narcissist you can bet money that it is. Again, we're talking about narcissists, so their form of gossip is going to be manipulative, and subtle, so very subtle you're likely to miss what's really going on. That said, some forms will be bad-mouthing someone purely to play the one-upsmanship game as they need to puff up their pathetic deflated selves. Another form might be to triangulate you with someone else. Again, the narcissist needs you to react on their behalf to either do something to someone, spread their gossip to malign someone else, or just to make you feel bad so they feel better about themselves. Chronic gossipers should be avoided at all costs, and that really goes without saying, but the most dangerous ones are the pathological narcissists. They weaponize gossip, playing everyone around them like puppets on a string. It's actually their main way of operating. As for me personally, my dad's rule in the house was absolutely no gossip. You don't listen to it, nor partake in it, mainly because it's destructive, and it's probably not even true. So I don't gossip nor do I listen to it, which kinda makes me a boring friend for most, but what's interesting is that my narc used this against me. He would play the quiet, agreeable guy around me, then went out and smeared me everywhere knowing that I keep to myself for the most part. That way I wouldn't hear about his smears because I wouldn't be looking for it, and I never suspected him for a minute. He mirrored me perfectly. Finally, for anyone that's had the most unfortunate experience of being with a narcissist or other toxic person, and are desperate to know what to look for in effort to avoid these disasters before they can manifest, I hope this helps a little bit. One thing we know for sure is that the narcissist has practiced their deceptive, destructive ways of hurting people their entire life, so they're really good at fooling most people most of the time. Sadly, it takes time for their mask to drop, and most of that time, they've already got their hooks into you. You will probably see that time as an investment and not want to give up on them, but trust me on this one, the sooner you let go of them, the better off you'll be in every single way. Save yourself, know the tells, then run like hell.